I go love. Ah, guys, did you just see that? Nengi and OZO are giving us couple goals, like the OZO. You guys call them OZO, right? That's what you guys call them. Anyway, guys, yesterday Nengi and OZO actually had a date night, and it was all a mushy mushy something. You get what I'm saying? Anyway, guys, welcome back again to my channel. My name is Vicky, and if you're seeing my face for the very first time, please consider to hit on the red subscribe button, subscribing to the channel, and do not forget to turn on your notification bell so that YouTube will inform you whenever I post a new video. And please give this video a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below. I really love to hear from you guys. Oh, so guys, Nengi and OZO are actually like, they have been doing couple goals. They have been busy, you know, doing everything together. And of late, ever since the day before yesterday was so that they actually spoke about their relationship. They had a date yesterday. And you see, you guys just saw it now. Nengi feeding OZO. Guys, are you that romantic? Of course you're not. Learn from Nengi. Anyway, guys, then this morning, OZO was telling Nengi he's going to make breakfast for her, and she was like, I'm gonna really enjoy it. And OZO was like, really? And she was like, that's how I enjoy every guy's meal. And I'm like, madam, rest, please rest, just let him enjoy this compliment that you're giving. Don't just look for a way to try and spoil it. Why are you like this? You get, and for some reason they've just been mushy mushy, lovey-dovey, and on each other's arms, and just being cool with themselves and loving themselves and doing, you know, So that's just what has been happening, the back and forth in Big Brother Naija house. And then let's talk about Tolani Badge and Erica. They were having a very lengthy conversation, and they were talking about she and the prince situation. And then Tolani Badge was just advising Erica on how she should make Kid Wire to chase after her, how she should like trying to give her this course, trying to, you know, teach her on how to make it happen. Remember that she actually did the same thing, and Prince is now the one, or she and Prince now, they're an item, and we are still watching them and hoping that that item that they have will not shall scatter, you get, because for some reason since they came to the house, Tolani Badge has been eyeing Prince, has been loving him, has been, you know, shooting her shot. And then day before yesterday night, they have a lengthy conversation, and then Prince actually, well, they've been sharing bed and they've been enjoying themselves and feeling cool with themselves, telling Erica not to sell herself short to Kid Wire and all that. And you remember that Erica has already said it, that when she's with Kid Wire, like, she knows that what she's actually doing with Kid Wire, she's going to, it's actually not going to end well, you get. And then even myself, I'm even scared for Erica, because at this point then, all of us, I know, even you that is watching it, you don't, even you that know the Kid Wire, you know that Kid Wire can be, it's a flirty person and might look like a playboy, and we are just so scared for her that I hope it doesn't end in premium tears. Because even the Erica herself, she actually knows that this thing I'm doing, it might not really end well, but she's helplessly, hopelessly, like, attracted to him, like she normally calls it. She says she's attracted to him physically, you get. And then, you know, some of us might be in such situation, and one way or the other, you might really not know how to handle it. Let's not just start acting as if Erica is foolish or something, because at this point, some of us have been in that situation or the other, where we just hopelessly, crazily fall in love with someone who we actually know that is not the best for us, or who we actually know that doesn't feel the same way for us. Because Kid Wire has been going about saying that he does not have a girlfriend. He said that to Nengi, that they are just enjoying themselves. And she too, she says that to other housemates, that they are actually just enjoying themselves, that they are not an item yet. And I just feel like, yeah, she's correct to an extent, because she's not in that position yet to demand some sense of loyalty and respect, especially in her presence, where he keeps flirting with other people. You remember I made a video of him even teaching Nengi of how to flirt with other people. So that's just it. I'm just so scared for Erica at this very point. But the truth of the matter is that she's not even helping matter, because each time you see Erica and Kid Wire, they are kissing, 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 kissing. In fact, Erica is the one all over him at this very point in time. And then Tolani Badge was just telling her that she should turn the table around and make him chase after her and make him be the one to long for her. I don't know how that is going to happen, but we are still watching, because at this point, Erica cannot control it. Erica cannot even, I'm not sure she can carry out that task that Tolani Badge is actually giving her, because at this point, she's yapata for grand. For where Kid Wire, but come, let me ask you guys, Who wouldn't fall for Kid Wire? The guy with the swag, the guy with the accent, the guy with the style, the guy with the bar. You know that with cash, you know that kind of thing. So it's very easy. The whole thing just makes it so frustrating for her to see if she can actually handle that. And then Prince and Tolani Badge, we are still having our eyes on them. I don't know if Prince has finally just like completely fallen, you get, but that's just basically for it. And then today they are having their Patricia Bitcoin tax, you get, and they shared themselves into six group of three each in a group, you get. And they are actually playing this game of a member in a group picks a question, just like they do in their trivials, in their Betway trivials, you get. A member picks question and then asks the member of his or her group, and the member of his or her group answers, and without the person giving her group member or his group member sign or trying to tell them the answer, you get. So they have to answer. It's a two kind of challenge, you get. The first round was picking questions, asking and the answer, and the whole question was boiled down around Bitcoin, Bit Wallet, and this cryptocurrency per se, you get. And then the second round was then you pick a question, like you pick a word, you pick from the box and a word, and then you just try to draw it. For instance, now if the word is clock or the word is time, you just try to draw it in a way that they will know that, okay, the word that is written there is time. And that's what they did. And at the end of it, no group actually won, but Biggie was so benevolent to actually make all the groups to have won. And it was just $500 was deposited in their Bitcoin wallet for the whole housemate. And that's just basically what they've been doing. And this evening now, they are actually preparing for their party, and me, I'm here to actually party with them, because anything that is going on in that house, it is me and them. Actually, we are 21 housemates in that house, and I am the number of 21 person, you get. So don't think that anything that is happening there, me, I'm not there. If you're dating, I'm the third person. If you people are fighting, I am the third person. If you people are laughing, you're doing the arena game, you're doing your tax, whatever they are doing, I am the third person, 21, or okay, let me say the 19th person that has not been evicted, and I will be the last person that will be evicted, because I'm going to be following them till the end of the show. So right now, Biggie has brought dresses for them, courtesy of AY stitches and the shoes, and they're just preparing for basically their party night. And I'll be bringing you guys the gist after the party. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below. What do you think about the Nengi and Ozo's relationship now? Are you thinking that relationship is going to sail, or that ship is going to sail? What do you guys think about it in general? Just leave it in the comment section. And then the Tolani Badge and Prince's relationship, is it going to work? Because at this point, Tolani Badge has given Prince rules and regulation. A man has to stick to it if he actually wants to be with Tolani Badge, because Tolani Badge has said that this time around, you have to work for me. The time I was throwing myself at you has passed, so you have to work to be in a relationship with me. So let's just see if Prince is actually going to do it, as Tolani Badge has said. And then Erica and Kid Wire, what do you guys think about the whole situation? Are you guys seeing that Erica is going to end in premium tiers? We hope not, because at this point, it's looking like Kid Wire is a playboy and she has just consciously or knowingly fallen for it. Thank you so very much for watching this video. Give this video a thumbs up, leave me a comment down below, and I'll see you in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, turning on your notification bell so that you'll be informed whenever I post a new video. Bye bye, see you in my next video.